Marcus. I want to take a few minutes of your time to talk about two critical care presentations. The first one is about anemia. You'll see anemia many times in your practice, and you may also be able to pick up the second presentation, which is sickle cell anemia. Starting with anemia, how do these patients present? Their blood labs, their hemoglobin, hematocrit, or red blood cells can all be low. They may complain of fatigue. They may show clubbing of the fingers. They may have B12 deficiencies, and this can cause sometimes a sore, bright red tongue called glossitis. Some causes of plain anemia can be heavy menstruation, can be pregnancy, can be, unfortunately, secondary or tertiary problems such as ulcers or polyps or, unfortunately, colon cancer. It can also be hereditary. Can be vegetarians that are not getting enough iron in their diet. We want to be sure that we rule out other disorders such as sickle cell or thalassemia when we talk about anemias. So patient education, recognizing and patient education is very important. Sources of iron, sources of folate. That's what you need to promote with these patients. Even if they're vegetarians, they can have spinach, lentils, bananas, fortified grains, and juices. We're going to do some studies on them. Iron studies, transferrin studies, serum ferritin levels to see how their iron storage is and see if perhaps they have underlying secondary anemias. The other exacerbation problem we're going to talk about here is sickle cell. Sickle cell anemia is an autosomal recessive disorder. These patients present many times with pain, abdominal and joint pain. The cells themselves, the red blood cells, are sickled. As a result of this, they actually get caught, and the patients have strong pain and complain of constant problems with joint pains and shortness. Some of the symptoms are the same. Shortness of breath, inability to do what they normally did. This is an autosomal recessive disorder. So what's good about it is you can almost figure out as far as the predisposition of children today if they are carriers and if they would possibly have problems with sickle cell. What we want to do with sickle cell, again, there's a lot of education. These patients present, number one, with pain. We want to make sure that pain management is assessed for them and they get on a good regime of pain management. Lately, they've been doing a lot of PCA pumps with them, which is fine. But we don't understand something like a basal would be very important with them to make sure they're getting titrated amount. We know with the gait control theory of pain how important it is that pain medication is titrated to keep the pain receptors down. Very important also is hydration. We want to especially avoid, once diagnosed with sickle cell crisis. What can cause sickle cell crisis? They can be dehydrated. They can be overdoing it, maybe too much alcohol. We want them to realize that they're predisposed to sepsis because they have trouble with their spleen. And we need to know for sickle cell crisis, we need to push fluids as much as 200 milliliters an hour. Again, to reiterate, anemia can be dietary. You want to assess as far as what could be the predisposing factors. See if the patients are in the typical anemia presentation. Sickle cell anemia, a little different with the joint pain. And again, education, 3 to 4 liters of fluid a day. No alcohol, and have a flu shot every year. Hope that helps a little with those two presentations. Thank you for your time.